In this tutorial, I'll show you how to take advantage of YouTube's automatic captioning to go in and have it automatic caption and then go back and correct those captions to make sure they're accurate. So I'm on YouTube's support page and it mentions that you may have to wait a little while for your captions to come through. You may have to wait overnight depending on the length of the video. And then they list some of the things that would cause the captions not to generate, such as complex audio. You know, if you have some machinery going in the background or music playing in the background over with the voice, then you might have some issues. Maybe the language isn't supported yet. The video might be too long. You might have like a poor quality microphone or something about the sound is poor quality, so it doesn't recognize the speech, or there's a long period of silence at the beginning of the video, or multiple speakers which overlap when they're speaking. So let me go ahead and jump to YouTube. So it's free to get a YouTube account through Gmail or Google, sorry. And once you're there, you can go to Creator Studio under your picture icon of your profile. And I'm going to upload a fresh video here with this plus icon over this camera. And when I click it, there's two options, upload the video or go live. I'm just going to upload a video. I make this public. It's fine with me. I'm going to click on Select Files to upload. And I'm going to navigate to my file. And this happens to be Jaws reading a table that's actually two tables combined. So I'm going to select my MP4 file, which is my video file. And it'll take a while to upload and process, and it'll tell you when it's done. So don't worry about the captioning at this point. What I'm going to do is pause the video after it uploads, and we'll come back to it, and I'll show you how to edit the auto-generated captions. One thing you might do while it's uploading is just give it the title that you want it to have. Jaws reading combined tables, and I'll write a description. This video demonstrates Jaws screen reader reading two tables that have been combined into one. It shows how reading order makes no sense to someone who is blind. Okay, so my processing's done. I'm going to go ahead and click publish. And there's the link to my video, and we'll come back to it later. Okay, so I'm back here in YouTube, and it's been a couple days, and I'm in my video manager looking at the video that I had uploaded. I'm going to go ahead and click on it to see if it has the closed captions. And when I play it back, I notice the little
with
CC button.
In both Word and
so right here are the automatic captions that YouTube added in. To edit these, go under Subtitles and CC at the top right. Click on English Automatic. Once you're on the Subtitles and CC screen, click on Edit in the upper right. So now you can see that these areas over here on the left, you can highlight them and click and change the wording if you need to. So you just play it back and listen and see if it's actually interpreting your voice correctly.
With tables in both Word and HTML, it's not a good idea to combine tables like you see here in this example.
I'm going to add a comma.
Or to merge cells. Right here we have.
Okay, so right at the end of cells, I need a period and I need a capital R to begin a new sentence.
Two tables basically that have been combined into one within Word. So this table on the left.
Okay, so I heard Word. This is the name of the application Word, so I'm going to make this a capital. And then I'm going to add a period after it. And so you work your way through this, just correcting your grammar and any words that you need to. Something you might encounter is having too many words on a line, actually multiple lines in the captionings. This is pretty long. I'll play it for you.
Assignment, maximum grade, 532-560, A, row 2, module 1, journal entry 10.
Okay, so what you can do is create an extra caption in between the two here. So let me try to do that right where it transitions to row 2.
60, A, row 2.
Okay. And so what I can do is back this off. I can go click the caption below it and click this plus symbol to add an extra one in the middle. And then I'm gonna take this row 2, 10 text and do Control X to cut it and Control V to paste it into the caption row below. And then I'm gonna have to go back and listen and see where it transitions so I can line these edges up. I'm just going to guess for now and draw it out, and we'll see how it works.
160, A, row 2.
Okay, so row 2 is really a little bit further to the left. Let me drag this magnifier so I can. If I drag it all the way to the right, I can see gaps. So let me slide this back and play it back again.
2-560, A, row.
Okay, so row 2 does actually kind of start right there,
Row
right?
2, Module 1, Journal Entry 10, Row 3.
Okay, so that one worked okay. And then I could do the same for this one down here at the bottom. And you just work your way through it, adding where you need to add captions, breaking apart things, and cutting and pasting and adjusting these sliders. And when you're done, you just push publish edits. Okay, so it says it's pending the publish. And I can go back and change these if I need to.